Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to build a Python snake game on Raspberry Pi 4 and we're going to control it with an Xbox controller. Let's begin. So today we're doing a Raspberry Pi 4 video and I want to gradually build out that Raspberry Pi playlist and hopefully you'll enjoy those videos, but I thought it'd be fitting to create the game Snake because I'm using Python. I know, it's whatever. To do this project, I'm going to use a Raspberry Pi 4. I'm going to take the top off here so it can cool down a little bit. I'm going to plug in the monitor here. I'm going to plug in the mouse and the keyboard. These are Raspberry Pi mouse and keyboards. You can use any USB keyboard mouse. I'm going to plug in my USB cable to the Xbox remote. It's just a USB to C connection that I use for my cell phone. And I'll plug it right in to the Xbox controller. We'll also need to plug in the power to the Raspberry Pi. And now we're all set. And the Xbox controller should come on. There we go. I'm not going to go through the entire code here, but as always, I will post it on the Facebook page. Right here, I'm going to Pixel so that I can get a background for the game. Otherwise, it's just going to be black. And here on pixels.com, I can get it for free. I need to put the picture in the same file that the source code is in. So that's what I'm doing here. The game is in this file, Pi4Games. So I'm going here and I'm going to name my file here for this picture. I'm just going to name it image one. There we go. Okay, now I'm going to go back here and open the file, the Pi4Games file here on my Raspberry Pi. And Tron 2 down there, that's the one that I want. Actually, let me open this again. Pi 4 Games, there we go. Open the Tron 2. And that was the name of my previous game. I think it has a copyright picture in it. I'm not sure, so that's why we're changing it. And you can change that here in the code at line 16 under background. Just take that out and put in your file name here, which is image one, and we got a black screen. Okay. All right. Let's figure this out here. All right. I figured out what the problem is. If you look here, this is supposed to be a JPEG right here. And I'm going to highlight that and copy it because I'm too lazy to type it. I'm going to go over here and I notice that there's no extension on this picture. So I'm going to take image.1 and give it a JPEG extension. Just like so, and then it should work. Click on OK. Close it out. Close the game out here. Restart it, and there we go. That's what it's supposed to look like. So here you see a background picture and the snake is green, the food is red, and when I eat the food appears in another position, which is good. It's what we want. Looks like it's lagging a little bit, but it's really not. Maybe it's just the recording. But as I eat the food, the tail gets longer. You crash into yourself, you get a game over screen right here. I added that as well. And also if you go out of bounds, you get a game over screen. And if you keep hitting A, I set it so that it resets the game. So it'll reset the food in different positions. So those are the three things that I added to this. Adding an Xbox controller makes it so much easier to play. I was going to use the arrow keys on the keyboard, but I thought I'd try for something different. I was also going to use a joystick from my Arduino kit, which I may still do that in the future, I don't know. Well, here I am, my score's 38. My highest is 54 on this particular game here. But before I end the video, I want to show you guys how to change just a couple things. So this code is commented out pretty well, so you can pretty much go anywhere and play with the values. Here we're going to go to the font, and we're going to make the font a little bit bigger. You may want it smaller. So let's just see what 90 looks like. As you can see, it's huge. The score is real big and kind of annoying, I would add. So I'm going to change that back to 50. Right down below that, you can play around with the color of the game over text. And right above that, you can play around with the color of the score text. So we'll just change this here to a yellow color. We'll turn it on here and in the game really quick, and you can see what the game over looks like. Now it's yellow, it's not red anymore. I changed the game over text back to red, but I want to scroll down here to line 146 and show you that you can shift the text to different positions using these values right here. So you can play around with that as well. And we'll just change them to 4 and see what that looks like here. Start the game and end it real quick. So you can see that the game over sign is shifted over a little bit. And right below that, starting on line 149, you can play around with the restart and end callers and positioning. So there's a bunch of different values. It's all commented out. Check it out, play around with it, see what you think. This will be posted on the Facebook page. I just switched back over to my PC, but I wanted to show you where the Xbox controller was programmed. Just under line 41 here initializes the controller. Just under line 90 reads input from the joysticks. And just under 94 is where the controller is mapped. Well, that's all I've got for today. I do appreciate you watching. Drop a comment in the section below and let me know what you think about the video. If you liked it, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Share it with all your friends, and I'll see you again very soon.